We regret to inform you that today Ben Shapiro has done something truly awful, maybe the worst things to come out of his mouth yet. He's a rapper now. These are truly horrifying times for us all. More specifically, Shapiro features on the anti-woke rapper Tom MacDonald's latest song called Facts. Here's a still from the music video featuring a super cool looking Shapiro. Super cool because he's mostly hidden. For copyright reasons, we won't be playing Shapiro's part of the song, but here are the lyrics to his verse, which I will do in my best Shapiro voice. Let's look at these stats. I've got the facts. My money like Lizzo, my pockets are fat. Homie, I'm epic. Don't be a wop. Dog, it's a yarmulke. Homie, no cap. Look at the graphs. Look at my charts. You're blowing money on strippers and cars. You're going to prison. I'm on television, dog. No one knows who you are. Keep hating on me on the internet. My comment section, all woke Karens. I make racks off compound interest. Y'all live with your parents. Nikki, take some notes. I just did this for fun. All my people download this. Let's get a billboard number one. I love that he's pushing for people to download it in the song. That's how desperate he was for this to go chart. In his limited one verse there, he says, please download this so that I can be a famous rapper and stick one to Nicki Minaj. Also, though, in fairness to Ben Shapiro, he did somehow rap it a lot cooler than I did it in his normal voice. Must have been auto-tune or something. I don't know how they did that. A lot of takes, probably. But apparently Shapiro was not kidding about that last line because he's been posting incessantly about the charts. Posting here on X, I just want to thank God. And I am Tom MacDonald and my parents who paid for 15 years of classical violin lessons so I could become the number one rapper in America. Of course, he's a violinist that tracks. We're now number one overall in iTunes too. On the way, we knocked off, among others, Justin Timberlake, Britney Spears, Megan Thee Stallion, Nicki Minaj, Eminem, and Taylor Swift. At I Am Tom MacDonald, and I have officially made hip hop great again, as was always my lifelong dream. Shapiro's ex bio now reads, Ben Shapiro, America's number one rapper. This is all very ironic, however, because Shapiro has claimed in the past that rap is not music at all. Here's a clip from 2019.
In my view, and the view of my music theorist father who went to music school, there are three elements to music. There is harmony, there is melody, and there is rhythm. Okay. And rap only fulfills one of these, the rhythm section. That there's not a lot of melody and there's not a lot of harmony. Mm. And thus, it is basically effectively spoken rhythm. And so it's not actually a form of music, it's a form of rhythmic speaking.
There is all of those things. There is harmony, maybe not super often. There's definitely melody. Ever heard of the hook, bruh? And there's definitely rhythm. It's maybe the most rhythmic music that there is. But I'm glad he's finally come to the light by having to do the thing himself. Kind of a typical conservative response there is you don't acknowledge any reality until it's your own, then suddenly you're embracing of it. But until then, anything different is scary and bad.
Yeah, so a fair show in America. I'll give some upsides here in a second as well. But first of all, congratulations to him. Here's one. He's now number one in rhythmic speaking.
He's always kind of been rhythmic speaking. He always talks kind of like this in a syncopated beat kind of way, like a AI robot.
Yeah, and you know what? I actually think that Ben's version should go to number one on Billboard.
Let's make it happen, folks. Download it, upload it, then download it.
Your hoodie player.
I like Ben's Ben Gleib's voice of Ben Shapiro better than I like Ben Shapiro's.
Please
voice.
Dub my lyrics of it over him doing it on the track and upload that somewhere. That would be amazing.
That's awesome. Let's try that. Okay. So guys, he's obviously being a giant hypocrite, but he's just trying to get attention. So it is what it is. That's the game. Hate the game, not the player, right? So as much as he said he hated rap, of course he was gonna rap at some point. You know why? Because the right wing also wants to be cool. That's why they always say like, oh, liberal Hollywood, we hate them. Oh my God, Ted Nugent's on our side. That's the best you got? And they're like, oh yeah, and Angelina Jolie's dad. And James Woods, and I hear he has a like they get so excited anytime the tiniest little stars on their side. So please spare me about how you don't like rap and you don't like liberal Hollywood. And almost everyone that works at Daily Wire actually was trying to make it in Hollywood and didn't. And so then they did this. So we covered that in a previous story. And it's okay. A lot of people don't make it in Hollywood, but they're doing great now. Look, here's me being over the top fair. I don't know that if we did a rap here, God forbid, okay, that it would go to number one. So look, they got a big audience for it, bless their hearts. So overall, I don't mind. But what I think was interesting is as I listened to the song, and yes, I did, I'm a real journalist, okay? two things stuck out at me, and it goes towards the right-wing mindset. They said over and over again, and it's in the picture, and the guy's wearing it in the sweatshirt, the main rapper dude, whatever it is, at McDonald's or Burger King or whatever his name is. And he says, I don't care if I offend you. And that's such a right-wing way of thinking, right? Because sometimes I offend people, but you know what? I care. So like every time we talk about religion, I'm not religious, but I'm so worried that I'm gonna offend religious people. Even though I think the whole thing's absurd, et cetera, et cetera. But even saying absurd, I feel bad.
After Cenk and I yelled at each other, we hug each other. He hugs me, he feels so bad.
That's true, okay? So you should care a little bit about offending. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't say your own opinions, right? But it's okay to say, hey, you know, maybe I hurt that person's feelings and that's not such a great thing, right? And then the second thing that I thought was the worst actually is near the end of the song. They explain, oh yeah, you people and this and that and all the people on that are libs and on that side. And then they go, and I'm a man and I don't respect you. Well, all right, brother. I mean, then if you're gonna go at it with that attitude, then you can't be bothered when we don't respect you. So, but if you ever criticize right wingers, you'll see they get super touchy. Like if you say, hey, MAGA's deplorable, they're like, how dare you? Like if you criticize Trump, they nearly have a heart attack. You say anything about them, they're so fragile. They get super offended. And if you tell them you don't respect them, they lose it. Start throwing feces on the wall and stuff. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't respect you there. Okay, so if that's your attitude, well then okay, don't cry when we rhetorically punch you in the face, which you more than deserve, rhetorically and politically, right? But they do, they cry every single time. So anyway, Sharon.
I mean, a lack of respect though, that's what rap battles are all about.
True that.
NWA, F the police, you know, nobody, it's about that. And that's why they go back and forth, East Coast, West Coast. I don't think you can call yourself a number one in the rap game unless we see a rap battle like 8 Mile, remember the movie? I mean, that's a perfect example of what you see here. I can hate the game and the player though, in this case. I don't know why they wouldn't call their buddy Kanye to maybe help and kind of, you know, produce this thing up the right way. But it's really cheesy. If this is an attempt to be cool and relevant, even the hoodies, they should be much more oversized, okay? And less, you know, put the hood up over your face a little bit because you could care less. It's not about you, it's about me. That whole energy that the rappers give off, they're not selling it.
Yeah, and I will say that one point too, to counter your point, Cenk, about, you know, saying I don't care if I offend you. In normal life, that is the right position to have, is to care if you offend people. But in the rap game, as a former rapper, which I've mentioned on air before, you gotta not care if you offend people in the rap game, because there's no good rap song that cares if you offend somebody. It really puts you in too weak a position to write some fire bars, and you just can't risk it.
No, that's totally fair.
Put out a parody.
Yeah.
He's gotta put out a parody. I mean, they're talking about people's mamas, kids, nothing's off limits, but put out a parody. I think it'll do well.
Yeah, so look, but the best rappers are, like Eminem did in 8 Mile, he's self-effacing. So he disses himself before you get a chance to diss him, right? And you see none of that here, so it lacks a certain humanity. The great thing about rap is how authentic it is, and at least it was, and you know, you hope it still is to some degree. And this feels super inauthentic. Anyways, we're having too serious a conversation about the freaking rap, okay, and its quality. But so look, I'll say, since we're now in the milieu of lack of respect, you know, and then we've all agreed that that's the.
You also can't use the word milieu in the rap game.
No, you don't think so?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, come on.
So okay.
To your boy.
So Ben Shapiro, I wonder if your next rap is going to be about how you polished Trump's boots.
Ooh, now you're getting your rap vibe, Cenk. That's the rap vibe.
Yeah. Popping.
Because I thought you were against Trump and you were concerned about this, that, and the other thing. But as soon as he got back into power and you think he's going to win, you're back down on your hands and knees, right?
No. Ooh, yeah.
Cenk's getting it now. Cenk is getting, I think you do need to release a rap track. I'll produce it, Cenk. I'll sing the hook. Sharon will sing the hook. I'll produce it.
See, we stand up to our own leaders. We stand up to our own party. We call, we spit out truth either way, okay? But you, on the other hand, what is it they say in Russian? I know they don't say milieu, do they? I think they say bitch, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so that would make
give
you,
him a beat.
That would make you Trump's bitch, right, Ben?
Yeah.
I'm not a beatboxer. You give him a beat, Sharon. I'm the rapper.
No. Don't do
if
it.
If I
don't
could,
do
I
it.
Would.
Don't do it. Okay. All right. Now that we, you know. So there you go. Back in your court. I didn't rap it, to be fair, though. Okay. So.
It was good.
I just use rap lingo.
Trying to take over the charts like he's some kind of anti-hero taking over Taylor Swift. Now it's Ben Shapiro?
Oh.
Oh, not bad. Okay, but you gotta work bitch in there.
That part.
Bitch.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.